Was there anybody that did not have a chance to submit a question that wanted to submit a written question? Okay. If you want to, this is the time. Go fill those out, and then I'm going to collect those, and then we will move on. Is there anyone else? Okay.
Thank you. I appreciate the opportunity to be here today. This auditorium is a little bit scary to me still. I graduated from this high school 20 years ago. I remember standing in this same spot with the spotlight in my eyes, singing one of the dance themes. I don't sing anymore, just so you know. I gave that up, except for funerals. So if any of you need one, I'll be happy to do that. After I graduated in college and a mission, I had the opportunity to finally get my sweetheart to say yes. We now have 6 wonderful children between the ages of 15 and 4, and they're really why I do all of this, and I think you can understand that if you look at those who you love. I appreciate you coming to something like this to hear firsthand what you can expect out of your elected leaders. I met my opponent for the first time this afternoon, and that's unfortunate. We haven't had the opportunity to be together and have people hear us. She wasn't able to make it tonight. But I think it's important that we become more informed, and I commend you for being part of that. If we're not informed as we vote, we have the tendency to be stuck basing our opinion on what we might hear in sound bites or attack. And it's been frustrating for me the last couple of days, especially as I've seen some of the things that have been thrown out there. My opinion, for what it's worth, we have one of the most qualified candidates for Weber County Sheriff that has ever run for that office in Weber County. And it's unfortunate to see what's going on in that race right now. You'll have the opportunity to hear from him in a few minutes. I'm a small business owner and operate several small businesses, and so I think quite a bit, what can we do in government to make things better for small business who creates between 80 and 85% of the jobs in this state? And I think of two different contrasts. The state of Utah, who almost on a weekly basis is being recognized more and more as the best fiscally managed state in the nation, as the best place for careers and jobs. And why? Because of the principles that are adhered to in this state: lower taxes, structural balance in government, less regulatory disaster, as I like to call it. Compare that to Washington: out of control deficits, regulatory overreach, and out of control taxes. We have a contrast. We can be different than Washington, and we should. We are different. We need to make sure that those principles are adhered to, not only at the national level, but all the way down to our local government as well. So that's going to be my focus as I have the opportunity to serve you in the Weber County Commission. Thank you for being here tonight, and thank you for being part of the process.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for allowing me to be here and spend a few moments with you this evening. My name is Ernest Rowley, and I'm running for re-election as your Weber County Recorder Surveyor. Recording and surveying are intimately connected with our 5th and 14th Amendments to the U.S. Constitution. As a land surveyor, I have conducted all of my business and professional affairs with honesty and integrity in protecting your constitutional right to property. I have testified before the legislature on bills that would affect our property rights, and I am a recognized expert and have legislators, attorneys, and others seek my opinion or advice in boundary matters. I graduated college in 1983, and I've been a licensed professional land surveyor for 21 years. Because there was a lack of education and training in the profession, I, along with others, have worked on legislation that has required a minimum 2-year degree before you can take the licensing exams. I'm a member of the State Testing Committee, which reviews and prepares the licensing exam. I've been involved in passing mandatory continuing education requirements for the land surveying profession. and as an adjunct professor at Salt Lake Community College. I have taught surveying for over 13 years. I've also taught high school students about the history of land surveying. The recorder surveyor's offices are vital in protecting our constitutional right to property. The recorder protects the chain of title that each of us rely on to prove that we have legal title. And it gives effect to the statute of frauds, which requires that all transfers of land be in writing. The surveyor's office protects the physical location of our boundaries. Each parcel of land in Utah is tied by measurements to the public land survey system, which was created by Congress in 1785. Once the government issues a patent to land, or a deed to land, the maintenance of the survey system is turned over to the state. The state, in turn, created the Office of County Surveyor in 1848 and charged the office with the responsibility of maintaining the survey monuments that all property deeds originate from. Because of the importance of these offices relating to property, it is vital that the office holder be qualified. I have the knowledge, experience, licensing, qualifications, and integrity to continue serving you and protecting your property. I ask for your vote for Ernest Rowley, Weber County Recorder Surveyor.
Surveyor, recorder. Thank you.